So you, it's kind of nice that we're talking at Comic-Con because I
Yeah.
feel like you have your own like Comic-Con origin story
Oh my God.
where
It is literally a Comic-Con origin story. This is like, I'm surprised I haven't become a superhero because it's that close.
Please tell
Oh my God. So for the last, next month is 9 years since I started this weird little project that has become my life. I run a series of blogs that is referred to as the Mark Does Stuff Universe, which is Mark Reads and Mark Watches, where I read and watch things unspoiled, film myself while doing so, and then write sort of like these analytical reviews talking about the things that went on with it, you know, telling personal stories, but also trying to figure out what's going on. Because I think that, especially with serialized fiction, which you get a lot in speculative fiction, it is really fun to try to figure out what is happening in a story and seeing the pieces fall into place. I started it on a bet here 9 years ago. I used to live in Los Angeles and I had an editor who sent me to Comic-Con but said the only reason or the only way I could be allowed to go and cover what I wanted is if I attended the panel for Twilight. So this was like the height of the Twilight obsession. I think it was when New Moon came out that year. And
I
so
was at, this was my first Comic-Con
was that year. That
that
was the
year.
year. So that was also the year people started lining up outside Hall H for the first time, like hours. Actually, I want to say it was the day before. So, excuse me, I was like, no, why would I do this? And then it was like free trip to San Diego to Comic-Con. Yes, of course I'll do it. Like, you know, it'll be 2 hours out of my life. It was not, by the way. It was like 16 hours out of my life because I had to get in line. I got here on Wednesday and people were already lined up. And so I had to get in line at like 4 in the morning on the day of the panel. And what ended up happening was I didn't really do what I was assigned to do, which was cover the panel. Because, I mean, and I'm sure you relate to this too. If you're in that room, sort of everyone gets the same information. So the best you can do is if you have really good photos, if you write a really good write-up, I feel like that's the only real way to stand out. So I was in line for Hall H with all of these Twilight fans who were saying things like, this is the best book series I've ever read. I think that this romance has made my relationship with my husband better. And like, just these like out of this world things. And I'm like, do you ever have that moment when people are talking about a thing that they love that you know nothing about and you think, maybe I should find out what it is? So when I got back home, I had ended up doing this feature on only the people in the line and interviewing them and being like, why do you like this? And why are you here so early? And not in a condescending way. I was genuinely like, why are you here? And my editor loved it and was like, I'm so glad you did this and ended up doing better than my actual Twilight coverage. So it was like, it ended up working out. As I was leaving his office, he made this like offhand comment and was like, you know, it'd be really funny if you read Twilight and wrote about it. I'd just love to get your take on it. And I was like, that's a terrible idea. And then a few days later, I made this blog as a joke for my office mates called Mark Reads Twilight. And because I had a full-time job, I only read one chapter a day because it was all I had time for. And, you know, it was just me trying to understand this book and being snarky and then just downright angry as the series went on. And it was never supposed to be a thing, and the whole internet found it. And I ended up reading all the Twilight books somehow. But it was all because of Comic-Con, because of this culture, and because the way that fandom sort of can change like the whole cultural landscape. Because now Hall H has its own Twitter account, which is really funny. I found it yesterday. I didn't realize it was an account just for the line. But like that is something that those Twilight fans, and like say what you will about Twilight, I said a lot about Twilight. That series changed like young adult literature, and we got so many more people to read. It changed movie adaptations. It changed movie soundtracks. Because, look, I don't care what anyone says. That first movie soundtrack is one of the best ever. That's one of the best
Very
Paramore
good.
songs ever. Anyway, I really like Decode. It's like my favorite. It's my jam. So, you know, like it's interesting how that property changed so many lives, even if you didn't like it. Because I ultimately didn't like Twilight, but that it, I can't deny it, changed my whole life. And this blog that I started as a joke then became a hobby and is now my full-time job. And I think I've reviewed hundreds of books and TV shows at this point, and life is weird.